Next up, welcome to day number two. Today, I'm going to talk about three signs of depression or anxiety in 2022. Now, what are the common anxiety or depression symptoms which you may go through throughout the day, but you ignore it? All right. So for anxiety, excessive feelings of fear and worry. Now, this can cause irregular sleep-related patterns as well. You may not sleep extremely well. You sleep too little, you sleep too much also. So excessive feelings of fear and worry, overthinking. Next up, a dry mouth, tension in your muscles, any kind of nausea, irregular heartbeat and panic attacks. These are common signs of anxiety. Now, when we talk about depression, when it comes to depression, there's chronic feelings of sadness or emptiness. You tend to get suicidal thoughts, or you attempt suicide as well. Third would be little or no pleasure in activities. So something which you used to love before, something which you used to enjoy on a very regular basis, you don't enjoy that anymore, be it in your personal life, be it in your professional life. Sleeping problems, sleeping related issues. You sleep too much, or you sleep too little, or you don't sleep at all, or you go on something like a binge watch marathon. You distract yourself completely in entertainment activities or in any other activities just to escape the thought of your issues or, you know, bad mental health. Appetite changes. Some days to fill yourself up, you know, emotionally, right? You eat too much. And some days where you don't feel like eating at all, you tend to skip a lot of meals as well. That is not normal. That is a sign of depression, be it in the first stage or in an acute stage. That is something which the therapist can decide for you. You do not have to diagnose yourself. But if you've been going through issues like this, take help. That is something which is very, very important. That is the whole idea, the point of making this video. Take help. It is required. You may not know what you are going through. You may not know that you're going through these signs, but a qualified counselor, a therapist, a psychologist, a psychiatrist can help you. All right? So, last but not the least, reduced energy levels as well. So let's say that previously you could work for 8 hours, 10 hours, 12 hours a day without any breaks or with little breaks, and you would still feel absolutely energetic. But now, if you do a 1 hour activity or a 2 hour activity, complete a few tasks, even for half an hour, but you still feel tired and you would be like, oh, that's it, I'm done for the day, then definitely some signs of depression are there. You're feeling low, you're feeling fatigued, you tend to feel very, very low on energy, you don't feel like doing anymore, which at the end of the day also affects your productivity. So your performance in your professional life is very much linked to your mental health. So if you want to outperform everyone, you want to be the best version of yourself on the outside, be it in academics, be it while studying, be it in your office life as well, or be it when you want to become the leader in your business, take care of your mental health first. There are a lot of issues, there are a lot of traumas, there are a lot of pains, there are a lot of experiences, there are a lot of range of emotions that you have been through. You, my friend, have been conveniently ignoring that just because the society tells you that if you take help for mental health, you go to a therapist, you go to a psychologist, you go to a counselor, which means you've gone mad. That's not true. That's not true at all. I'm saying this with the highest amount of intensity, that it is not true at all. If you are taking the right help, you're doing a favor for yourself. You're saving your life. So that is something which is very, very important. Something which you truly, truly need to understand. That depression, anxiety, the way we throw these terms around, it's not a joke. It's not a joke at all. When you tell that, oh, I'm suffering from anxiety, oh, I'm suffering from depression, you throw it around as well. But chances are you might be feeling low on certain days. Chances are you may not be in your element on a particular day, but you don't self-diagnose yourself. These are symptoms, yes, that is there, but get the right kind of guidance, get the right kind of help first, and then get clarity as to what is exactly going on. And then also one more very important thing that I would like to share here is that a lot of people feel that, therapy is expensive, or getting mental health counseling is expensive, or more importantly, that if you're going to a psychologist, going to a counselor, they are always going to put you onto medicines. No, not every psychologist, psychiatrist is going to put you onto medicines. Psychotherapy can also help. Sessions can also help. Counseling can also help. First, get the right consultation, then get more clarity. It's not always about getting addicted to medicines. No doctor wants to do that. So that's the most important thing. So understand what you are feeling. Probably take a list of how you feel throughout the day, of what you have been feeling in the past few days. You might get some clarity that you may go through a few symptoms like these, and then get the best counseling required. Super. All right. See you in the next episode. Thank you so very much.
Help Talks are daily health-related talks held at Health Education Library for People, Mumbai, India. For more information, visit www.healthlibrary.com. Subscribe to Help Talks channel. Be better informed about your health.